Hey coach, what's going on today? Happy to have you here. To now we're going to talk a little bit about here. Let's move this out of the way. We want to make sure you can see, how I started our water polo club. So, just very short story on kind of went down. We moved from a really hot spot of water polo, which was California. I was college coaching there for 10 years at Whittier College and Loyola Marymount University, the D1 level. And we moved to Texas. California is expensive. We moved to Texas to, kind of figure things out. And I started the water polo club in 2020. And everyone kind of knows what happened in 2020. We had a 12 year olds and under, which is a great start. And then we practiced for three practices and then COVID. And so we basically just had to shut down and had no pool space, couldn't rent anywhere, extra happened. And then once we got pool availability, we started again. And we started again, we were able at one location. And I'll talk about location at the end because it's very, very important. We were at, and it kind of shows it in how we did things. Start at one location. And we've got a super small number. And then after a while, we get to move back to a more central location, and the numbers just go through the roof. So, location, location, location. I say at the bottom of our thing right here. So, first things first, you have a couple options on insurance in the United States for water polo. You don't have to, but if you want to play games and stuff like that and be insured, it's super easy. You have two options: American water polo, USA water polo. American water polo is quicker and cheaper if you just want to form practice. Depending where you are in the United States, there's not many American water polo clubs in Texas, the South. There are some in California. It's more of a Northeast type thing. So if you're in Northeast, look at American water polo. But we want to spread American water polo elsewhere. USA water polo is pretty much throughout the United States. It's a little more costly, but there is a little more opportunities to playing games. You have to weigh your differences. And if you want to ask me and contact me, throw something in the comments, and I can give you some more details against American versus USA Water Polo. Shoot me a text message on the number that is on the screen, at the beginning of the video. Peach jar, can't emphasize peach jar enough. Best of the best. You should look it up to see if it's in your area. Peach jar is literally you make a flyer, and this is how we started our club. You make a flyer, and you can pick the schools you want to send it to. So you basically send it to 10 schools. It'll broadcast that out to every parent with an email address that has an email address. And so you can have your flyer, they can click on it. That's how we basically started our club and advertising. It was going straight to the source, go to parents that want programming. Pardon me. And then for us, we were in luck. So Texas was kind of starting a UIL program, which is the governing body here for sports, and it was pumping up water polo. And so we got an advantage there to start that sport. If it starts, if there's not a lot of water polo in your area and you want to try it, eventually, if you have enough clubs and enough kids playing in high school, maybe it'll become a high school sport. A good way to do it, if you can't start out with little kids, is just get a base of high school kids first. So what you want to do is just if you go to your local high schools, if you're a water polo coach that's not a high school coach, if you are a high school teacher already and you want to coach club, then you have a high school water polo team, pretty easy to get kids, right? You should have about 20 girls, 20 boys. Tell them, hey, you want to get better? Let's play some club. And then you should have about 40 kids. Not all will play club, but then the ones that didn't play club will see the ones that did play club and how good they got. And it pretty much is a self-explanatory thing. But with that being said, if you're trying to build your club, you need to build it from the pyramid, diamond pyramid, ground up. Young kids is the base of your pyramid. The top of the pyramid is your elite high school athletes. You should be trying to sell. Not only the key here is, what if you're in your area like Texas where I'm at, water polo wasn't really known about. So what am I supposed to do? Well, I have to sell both swimming and water polo. So the key is to focus on selling the swim, and the water polo is extra. And then the kids, I love swimming, but the kids tend to lean towards more water polo than swimming at times, depending on the kid. And so they will eventually, you can do more water polo, but you brought them into your base and you contact those parents like, hey, I can teach your kid how to swim better. And we will play some water polo, which is a team sport. Again, the question becomes, is there water polo already in your area or are you the only one? Reach out to me and we can talk about it and how to build that business and make sure to help you start your water polo club, where to start from scratch. We have that all set up with our program and we can basically help you build things from the ground up and everything's built out for you to help you do that. Are you the first club? So there's like, is there water polo in your area at all? Are you the first club in your area? Is it just high school and there's no clubs? Well, if you're the first club, I mean, you know, I have a great opportunity to actually capitalize on the kids that want to get better because most kids cannot play with their high school coach at times with their high school coach out of the season. Okay. Only during the summer is that an option. So those are some really quick things that you can kind of start to look at in terms of how to start your water polo club. Shoot me a text. We can go over things, make it a lot easier for you to expound upon it. We can get on a Zoom call and I really go over it and how to better really explain how things work. Then my thing at the bottom there at the sheet is location, location, location. My group was at like 7 kids at one location for a full year. And then the moment we moved to a more centralized location that was closer for parents, it went up to 50. 7 to 50. That's a huge jump. So let me know if you want any help. I'm here to help. Want to really help you guys out and help you expand your business and start. And thanks for filling in.